Hello everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play Xanadu for the MSX. So, I finished off all the monsters roaming around outside. I probably missed a handful back in level 8, but I think by and large we've got them all. So it's about time to move on to level 9, and level 9 again is a slightly tricky one. It has a bunch of these things, the, what do you call them, anvils. Bunch of one-way exits, bunch of one-way entrances, a lot of places to get nice and trapped. This isn't one of them. You can go through these anvils and you will fall down this hole where you'll basically end up in the corridor down here, so it's not a big deal. Also in this level, extremely strong creatures, much stronger again than in the previous level, so if in the previous level we could still sort of attack them with our melee weapon, in this level really you will get owned pretty bad if you try. This Utjok, for example, would probably kill us in one hit. Although, right now, just about anything would kill us in one hit because our health is so low. Our max hit points are a lot better than they were in the previous video, as you can see. That's due to me picking up two or three of those mushrooms I was talking about. I'm also up to 7 elixirs. I believe I could have gotten one more. I think there's still a wyvern in the previous level, but... oh, and one more in the tower, of course, so I think we could be up to 9 by now, but 7 will really kind of be enough to get us through the game. Let me see, what else? Oh, yeah, I'm just pulling up some monster information here, and having a look here as well. So yeah, in this level there's a couple of towers we want to clear against. In this one there's 3 in total, and a bunch of these outside monsters, and I figured I'd show you the outside monsters first. In this case, because we are close to the spawning area of these guys, I think I am going to use... and because there's only 2 of them around here, and not that many others, I believe it's probably a good idea for me to use a Demon's Ring for these guys instead. So I will do that. I will equip our Demon's Ring. Then I will wait for the purple guy to come into view so we can actually hit him. Hopefully. There he is. There is kind of a teleport up here, isn't there? I keep seeing little... Oh, here we are. Yeah, there is. Well, that's actually useful. Yeah, because it's a little bit tricky. You can't actually see it very well, but they are, there are 2 of these sort of anvil-heavy areas. And as you can see, this one actually leads to a different path. So, let's see, what's the most efficient way to do this? I think we'll just use our Demon's Ring and start killing these guys. Again, the benefit of the Demon's Ring is mainly that monsters will still respawn, unlike with the Hourglass. So if you have a tight concentration of a lot of monsters that you want to kill in the same area, the Hourglass will do perfectly fine. But if you have one monster that you want to make respawn 2 or 3 times and then keep killing it over and over, then you will definitely need your Demon's Ring. Just checking, but the Otyuk's drop red potions, so yeah. Nothing to worry about here. Just kill this guy and steal his loot. Hopefully I'll be able to make it respawn quickly and fight it again. There it is. Come back here. So yeah, these Otyuks, nice experience, not the greatest, but red potions are always worth it, of course. They will definitely be our main source of healing from here on, because healing is going to be very expensive now. I think we're also ready to upgrade our level a couple of times. If you were paying attention a second ago, you'd see that my fighter experience is gone way, way up, thanks to basically doing this to all the monsters in the previous level. I would like it very much if you move to the left a little bit, Otyuk. Guy. Oh, whatever. Yeah, we're at 7,500 fighter experience now. 7,500, I'm sorry, fighter experience now. As opposed to our... What was it before? 200 something. And that's just from the one level, so clearly great progress has been made. And still is being made. I think we can raise our fighter level up above our wizard level by now. Although wizard levels I think are slightly easier than fighter levels. I think you need slightly less experience to level your wizard side than your fighter side. although I might be wrong about that one. There we go, kill some more of these guys. There's actually only one spawn left after this one, and then we will go after some other ones. And hopefully our demon's ring will last long enough to kill a couple more of them. Although it's probably gonna run out any second now. Oops, I fell through. Oh well. I guess we'll get the last one later. These guys are extremely powerful, so be very careful about attacking these without any protective items, as I'm using right now. Good thing is they never move, even if you do have if you're not invisible, so you'll always be able to find them in the same place, as you saw just now. So for experience, it's pretty nice because you could just stay in the same place and kill them over and over. Although I do have to say, they have extremely high agility, and what that means, I will show you a bit later. Oh yeah, the dark... what were they called? Dark Stalkers or something? Yeah, Dark Stalkers. Those are extremely nice because they drop the best items, I think, in the level, pretty much. So we'll definitely be going after those in a little while. But we won't approach those from the other side because obviously we can't get through here. And you cannot attack monsters diagonally, so if he's to the upper left of me, or upper right of me, I won't be able to attack him through these diagonal paths. They have to be above, below, left or right of you. Yeah, you know what, let's just get it over with. I'll show you why these guys are so powerful. So we'll use another demon's ring and we will try and easily kill them again, but... oh, I think I upgraded my agility a little bit in the meantime. Last time I tried to attack the third spawn, their defense was so high that I couldn't even hit them, even though they couldn't hit me either. But I guess... or maybe it's the fourth spawn I'm thinking about. That might be possible too. There we go. Not really anything of value, but... extra lamps never hurt, and the experience is nice. Yeah, see, this is the one I was thinking about. Clearly, we are not going to be able to kill this one with our fighter attacks. So let's just... oops. Protected against corrosion, so we'll have to use our tilt instead. Oh, it's actually magic proof against everything, so we will just leave it alone. Yeah, these guys aren't coming out, so we will quickly try to go to the other side. And yeah, we'll have to open this one sooner or later anyway, so let's see if we can... actually, it's too high. Let's just go to the shopping area instead. Sadly, I believe the only way out of here is through these doors, but at this point we have so many keys that it really doesn't matter that much anymore, I don't think. Although we do have to save a bunch for level 10. These guys again, these Ixels, extremely powerful if you don't have a demon's ring to keep you safe. But also again, pretty nice items from these guys, not the very best, but... worth looting. Some more of these guys. Another couple of spare lamps. Some more of these guys. I think vaults pretty much always drop poison, so... I'll just use my magic to get rid of the last one. Pretty good experience though, so still worth killing them. I'm gonna try and get my fighter experience up to 1,000,000, and after that probably start working on my wizard experience a little bit, make that catch up. 1,000,000 sounds like a lot, but as you can see, it's going pretty quickly right now. Just checking my time here. Yeah, we are running slightly low on time, so... I think we'll be cutting off pretty soon. Try and show you a couple more monsters. I think we've seen enough Otyogs for a while. Oops, no. I do want to kill this guy. So yeah, clearly now it is becoming evident why it's a good idea to hoard your items in the early game, just so you have plenty of them to get rid of the monsters in the last few levels that are pretty much invincible if you don't have these items. Or of course if you just magic them all to death, but yeah. Ideally you want to level your fighter and your wizard more or less evenly. And that's our demon's ring again. I guess one more thing we can do in this video is visit the temple. I'm not going to bother going all the way back to the king anymore at this point, because really we've got plenty of stuff to deal with everything right now. There's nothing I particularly want to level above anything else, so just getting some of the basic upgrades is fine at this point, I think. So let's see at this point how many we can get. We're at 500,000 wizard experience, 800,000 fighter experience, and we haven't been to the temple in quite some time, so we should be able to get quite a few levels now. Let's see how we do. One fighter level, two, three, four, five. Ah, over to wizard, one. Oh, just the one, okay. So, very nice, we are now officially a superhero. Our hit points have grown up to almost 500,000, and yeah, very clearly our strength is getting up there, our intelligence is also becoming pretty respectable, our agility has gotten a very nice upgrade, and so is our magic resistance, so very nice all around, I'd say. We are going to have to be a little bit more careful when it comes to food at this point, because it's going to get more scarce, or at least we're going to be running out much quicker, so I think I'll just invest in a little bit of extra food, just in case. Should be okay for a while, but, you know, it doesn't hurt to be safe. Oh, and let me show you this as well. If you fall down here, and you want to get back up there, the way to do it is to get all the way to the top, but if you do a normal jump, as you can see, you won't be able to make it. And because of these stalactites, you won't be able to do a double jump. So the trick is to step to the right, and then immediately jump. You'll be able to jump off the air and hopefully make it to the end. So let me show you here real quick. So one to the right and then immediately jump and you land up on this thing here. Okay guys, I'm just going to run around and kill a couple of more of these critters, and in the next video I will, unless I find any particularly interesting monsters that have good loot or whatever, I might show you those, but if not then I will meet you back in the next video where we will probably start taking on some of the towers for this level. So once again, thanks for watching guys, and I will see you in the next part.